Hello, my name is Randy Norton. I work for the University of Arizona. I'm director of the Safford Ag Center, and I'm here today to tell you a little bit about some of the work that we're doing looking at precision control of nematodes in cotton production systems in Arizona. What we're doing out here in Buckeye, Arizona is we've got in our third year of a research project looking at using spatial data to precisely control nematodes in the soil. We know that the distribution of nematodes is tied very tightly to the amount of sand that's in the soil. So the higher the sand, areas in a field that have higher sand levels will typically have higher nematode pressure. And so what we're able to do is utilize this information or this relationship to go in and target specific areas in a field that have high concentrations of sand and also high concentrations of nematodes. And we can apply our nematicide in a site-specific way where we are applying it only to those areas where we know we have nematode pressure. So our first technique in order to quantify the variability in the soil texture in this field is we do what's called a Veris survey. And this is a implement that we pull through the field. You can see a picture of it right here in front of you. We use that implement to measure the electrical conductivity of the soil that gives us a direct relationship to the soil texture or the amount of sand that's in the soil. From that data we can then develop a map, and you'll see the map in front of you right now for this particular field. This is a soil texture map. The lightest green colors are areas where the sand is the highest, and as you move to the darker green and then into the lighter blue and the darker blue, those are areas of less sand or where the soil texture becomes finer. And we know that our nematode distribution will be, or we hypothesize that our nematode distribution will be the highest in the lighter areas of the field. The light green, which is the sandiest areas, which is where we hope to find the most of the nematodes, that we will then direct our applications into those areas to control the nematodes. Okay, we're out here now doing some directed soil sampling based upon our Veris soil texture map. We use this handheld GPS that gives us an image of the map on the screen that we can then use to move around through the field and take samples that are tied directly to soil texture. And that allows us to then validate our map that we have for soil texture and validate that with respect to nematode populations. And so what we'll do is we'll go out here into the field and we'll take soil samples, and really what we're trying to get a sample from anywhere from the top 6 to 10 inches of soil that we'll pull a sample. And in any given area, say for example in zone 1, we'll pull maybe 20 to 30 separate cores from that area. We'll collect the sample, put the sample in a plastic baggie, and then keep the sample out of direct sunlight. It doesn't need to be on ice, but it needs to be out of direct sunlight. And then we can then take that sample to Dr. Mike McClure, who's our extension nematologist, and he will run those samples for nematode populations. And then we can take that data and validate our soil texture maps.